Hi, welcome to another edition of KK Showbiz. My special guest today is the gorgeous and dashing Sona Walia. You're on your promotional tour at the moment with Nachale. How's that been?
Yeah, it's been quite busy, but it's good response, and trying to go, you know, to Midlands, London, and make sure it gets played on radio, and that's all really. But it's nice, it's quite enjoyable as well, because you learn as well quite a lot.
Where was it shot?
Delhi.
Delhi. And how did that come about? Because obviously it's a project you've been planning for a little while.
Yes.
How did that all come about?
This time we were planning for just a single track. And we started off with the concept of a wedding song. Again, once again, traditional Punjabi song.
Sure.
And so there is folk songs, bolia, just Punjabi bolia.
Sure.
And then to be like a wedding scene, you know, with the dancers, boys and girls, and all the family members. And then the best thing, we came up with like a team in Delhi. Excuse me. So that's where we went.
Good. To. Okay, I'll tell you what, let's have a look at Sona Walia's Nachale first of all.
We'll be right back.
ਰੜਕੇ ਸੋਹਣੀਏ
ਰੜਕੇ
ਤੂੰ ਨੱਚਦੀ ਮੇਰਾ ਦਿਲ ਤੇਰੇ
absolutely amazing. And if you haven't seen it, this is the single. This is my copy, so you'll have to get your own. Sona Walia, that's absolutely amazing track, and I've played it for the last 2 weeks on Sabres Radio Nachle, and it is, as you said, a traditional track, but you are full of energy, and especially in dancing, and I've said this before to you, you've got a lot of energy, especially when it comes on stage as well.
Back
a little bit back, and how did you get into the world of music and entertainment?
Okay, long story.
Long story.
Well, I'll make it short. Okay. Well, I've been just singing. I had interest since I was a little girl.
Right.
And I used to sing religious songs.
Okay.
In Gurdwara Sahib,
mm-hmm.
and Sikh temple. And then music was my subject in school. Then college, I took vocal music, and I did graduation in vocal music. And professionally, I started off here in UK because I wanted to bring my singing forward. And I was just thinking, this thing I really need to focus because I wanted to. So my uncle, Baldev Narang, he's a classical vocalist. And he was in India that time. I went to India, I went to him, I said, I really want to just help me. So he introduced me to Mr. Tejwan Kitt, who is a Punjabi music, famous Punjabi music director.
Good.
So he was in UK at that time. So I came back to UK, met him. And that's how it all started.
Okay, and when was that? How far back was that?
We're talking about this thing was 2007.
Right, okay. So then that takes us nicely into your first album, which was?
Resham Di Dori.
Nate.
Yes.
Okay, tell us about that.
Wow, if I just think back, it's like it was so much excitement.
Yeah.
I'm still excited.
Yeah,
but
of course.
It was like my first album because this was my dream always.
Mm.
And we were thinking to make my debut song, which was with Apache Indian, like introductory song. And another thing was singing with Apache Indian.
Yo, so we tell him stop. You're looking stunning and you're looking so hot. Let me see you ready and come dance on this spot. Your sexy body figure, judge, I know with the shaka. This your ragamuffin that on this spot. Sing. Now you're looking stunning and you're looking so hot. Let me see you ready and come dance on this spot. Your sexy body figure, judge, I know with the shaka. This your ragamuffin.
Yeah, with the Sona Walia, that's absolutely amazing, and that was actually on UK's number one soap, EastEnders, as well. How did that come about then?
You know what? It was a complete surprise for me because I had messages saying that congratulations, your song is on EastEnders, and I'm thinking because I don't watch.
I don't.
So I didn't know. I said, okay, I have to watch repeat. Was there and they picked
it's
up
amazing
the song.
Feeling,
it was,
isn't it?
Yeah, it was. It's a big achievement for me.
And after that, you got other awards, and then we come to your second album, which is
Kuri
Punjabi. And how did that come about?
Kuri Punjabin.
Kuri Punjabin. Okay.
Yeah. Punjabin is a female Punjabi girl, basically.
Yeah, I gathered. I do know my Punjabi.
Second, that was more, you can say, more traditional, more Bhangra based, because the first one was, you can say, experimental. So there were like different styles of Punjabi songs. It was rapping and sad song, romantic, traditional. But the second album, Kuri Punjabin, was more like dancing.
Sure.
Bhangra.
With the, because they're glassy.
Gotcha.
And you'll have to do that.
Not.
Yeah, so let's this one is Kach De Glassy from the album
Kudi Punjab.
Yeah.
Sare ve tabar vich sareya to soni mere vargi ve tenu har na peoni haaye sare ve tabar vich sareya to soni mere vargi ve tenu har na peoni jad marzi tu kad leya shak mundiya jad chahi kad leya shak mundiya ve mind kach de glassy vang ਗਲਾਸੀ ਵਾਂਗੂ ਰੱਖ ਮੰਡਿਆ ਤੂੰ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਪੁੱਛਦੀ ਗਲਾਸੀ ਵਾਂਗੂ ਰੱਖ ਮੱਖਣਾ
Sona, you've had quite a few other recognitions as well, one which was from the Parliament as well.
Yes, that was in 2010.
And how did that come about?
I was given recognition because of my Punjabi songs contribution towards Punjabi culture in Britain.
That's amazing.
It is.
You know, when you think about it, going back a few years back, Asian female artists did find, even now maybe, difficult to get into the industry.
Yes.
How difficult has it been for you?
I think I can say like not too difficult, and I can say not too easy either.
Mm.
Right, at beginning it was hard to get noticed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, make sure you know your songs are there, get played and channels, people notice, you know, that like beginning is hard.
Mm.
And then afterwards you just have to once you get response from audience, like in my case, when I got awards from different places, then it just gave me reassurance that I'm on the right track and something I enjoy. So I carried on. So so once you know, you are basically, you know, on the right track, and then you just have to keep
Final going. Question then, how would you sum up your journey in this world of music?
One word, enjoyable.
Mm.
Really enjoy. And I've learned a lot for the last 4 years, especially in Punjabi language itself. I've learned so much here as compared to what I did in Punjab. So it's amazing,
right. Really. And what would you advise, because there are would-be singers out there, many young female artists who are making wonderful videos.
Yeah.
And I'm not knocking them, but the song doesn't go anywhere. What would you advise, generally I'm talking about?
For female artists, basically it's just focus what they're doing. And they really need to have a good team.
Mm.
So.
Good team.
Good
they should
team.
Get Kittu.
Why not?
Does he only work for you? You only make your music.
No, he's got so many different artists, very
famous,
like, for example, Ravindra Garwal.
Okay, so he does mixture and obviously looks after your. Sona Walia, this has been an absolute pleasure, it really has. I know we've been planning to meet for a long time.
I know.
Get you down here on KK Showbiz. And on behalf of our team, and obviously yourself being here, really want to thank you for coming.
Thank you so much, and I'm just so thankful to each and every person of your team. Thank you.
Thank you. That's Sona Walia on KK Showbiz. And if you want to contact Sona Walia, it is her website.
SonaWalia.com.
There you go, simple as that, SonaWalia.com. Her tune's on iTunes as well. I want to thank everybody here, and also Suresh from Midas here in Leicester.